Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Master Bastard. I am Terlet.
I'm Hamtackle.
I'm Sir Chapsworth.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, once again. So what are we going to start off with, folks? Anybody have any poop stories this week? Poop stories. Normally we have lots of poop stories. Stories centered around...
Poop.
No?
Yep.
Oh, that's right. Ramtang is not here this week, folks. We apologize. Our dear friend Ramtang is away at a wedding. Not his own wedding, a friend's wedding.
No. Yeah, he could get into polygamy, but...
You know what's funny?
It's a bad idea.
I saw him today, and we were both at a department store.
Uh-huh.
And he said he had to go poop.
Oh, no.
So like, there's still go. Somehow yeah. makes it into uh-huh. here a... Yeah. Some Ramtang pooping story. Yes. Still makes it
a desperate somewhere. Race to poop. Was it like?
No, it was. I gotta go. Shit. Yeah, we're gonna go.
Like a turtle head.
I gotta go dump a bucket of gravy out real quick.
It's like turtle head poking. Awesome. It's like peeking out. It's like trying to get sunlight.
Let's work out his tummy. He's got a tender tummy.
I do have one poop story.
Oh, Chapsworth.
First time I pooped at work this week.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Why?
Does it take you a long?
Because it's usually just.
Does it take you a long
right
time
in
to
the
like
morning
a, to like trust a place before
no.
you feel comfortable?
No, because it's very regular.
I doubt
you know,
it.
Right
I bet you got to work and had to and just held it all day sweating, just in your cubicle, just sweat dripping off, just clenched.
If I've eaten spinach, yeah.
If I eat spinach, that's going. But that's like Tuesdays and
or
Wednesdays.
Kale or any fucking thing like that with lots of fiber and cellulose.
Well, see, I think you're missing the boat here because, frankly, if you're on an hourly clock, one of the things you should be doing at work every single day is any of your bowel movements, because that, sir, is extra break.
Yeah, which you so pointed out many times. But I utilized the disabled stall.
Oh yes, that's the way to go.
It felt like a mansion. I was shitting in a mansion.
We work in the same building, and I know that stall you talk about. Uh-huh. So that's a good one. It's the most used.
It's huge.
The most used. But
the toilet seat was warm.
They cleaned it a couple times a day.
What did they have a quad that worked there at one point? They needed like an extra large, like you know, RoboCop sized bathroom. Or
no, what? We just work with some walking monsters.
Oh, yeah. Extra obesity.
Oh yeah, people that exist only. To
is it like people. a trench toilet, like one that's like reinforced?
No, it's
literally just a trench. It's just a big gaping hole in the floor, and there's handles on the wall. You just grip onto those handles and try to unleash.
And there's a refrigerator, I assume.
Well, it's full of delicious beverages.
I noticed that as I would push, that there would be the extra echo in the bathroom.
What, are you, like, audibly pushing? Is that what you're... Well, you're one of those? Jesus
No. Just, you know, the normal...
Dude, I will even... time my splash as good as possible because I don't want to embarrass anybody in there. Usually I work at a place with a lot of people. There's going to be somebody in the stall.
I'm a shy shitter too. I am.
So I just try to be, you know, considerate. And then other people are like, come in, whistle in, sit down. Oh, oh my God.
I hate
spray farts. Okay. Wipe. Walk out of there like nothing's fucking going on.
Kind of like where you're genuinely concerned, you're disgusted, but you're like, I hope everything's like okay. That sounds like, that's deadly.
Well, I just think, motherfucker, do you not have anything private in your life? Like,
no shame.
I'm silent with it too. I listen at the door and I'm like, it sounds like somebody just came in and there's the sound of uh-huh. peeing yeah. and they have left. I don't think there's anybody in here. Blam, blah, 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 blah.
Well, see, I listen for the washing your hands cue, only not everybody does it.
So you're
waiting. So you sit there and you're like, I thought I heard a squeak of a door, but I'm not comfortable until I hear that. No paper towel going, nothing.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
You still
sick
here?
Bastard.
Are you listening outside my stall?
Am I going to like come out there and you're going to be like staring
it
at the
It kind of turns you into like a crackhead. You know, you're like looking and making sure nobody's there.
I wish they would just turn off the lights when they leave.
You blast a real forceful shit.
Be able to shit in silence in the dark.
You leave the stall to a slow clap from a creepy gentleman just smiling at you. That was great.
Need help washing your hands?
I love how Ramtang's not even here and we'd still do
this. Gravitate to poop.
It's easy fun. To talk about.
No, but you know what? There is one, ritual.
Let me finish, though, real fast. The reason I don't shit at work is because I wake up usually, take a shit, get home.
I'm telling you, you got to hold that gut buster in and shit on
company. I can't.
You got to shit on company.
I wish I could.
Over the years, I've made it 10 o'clock, around 10 o'clock every day, folks.
I will train myself.
Meet me. Nice. Meet me there if you're listening to this and you work with me.
There is a stall with a hole in it.
No,
hole full of glory, folks.
I'm not gonna say the word.
I mean, I'll jerk you off, but I'll be pooping while I'm doing it. Yeah. I have to get back to my desk. I got a lot to do.
That's the best kind of handjob. Anonymous and shitting.
Not a shit-covered handjob, right? Not,
you know,
not
it's all business.
Well, you could. If you think about it, that would lube up for a good long time.
Yeah, anything squishy you can use as lube, I guess.
I know. What really could go wrong?
What's the strangest thing you guys ever used for lube? Like, even in your high school years where you're desperate for just experimentation?
You don't need lube.
Tartar sauce?
No, yeah, you just...
I sense tartar sauce out of Chapsworth. Is that a fact?
No, not at all. You don't need lube at that age. It's when you're, like, in your 30s. And the girls are starting to dry up is when you have to, you know, use spit or, you know, use, you know, reach up in there, moisten.
Dried up girls? You just put a little effort in the foreplay there, pal. I'm not no, just you just hop on top and start a rocking.
It's real dry, but I'm going to come anyway. Open your eyes when I'm fucking you.
Uh-huh.
Well, you know.
Is that where this went?
I've met girls who've dated before. I know how that goes.
Anyways, hold on a second.
Oh, penises.
We missed a ritual.
Oh, yes. We did. Which one?
Me forcing it.
Oh, the disgusting shot, folks. Almost every week, we take shots of liquor that just tastes terrible.
It's not just that they taste terrible; it's that they are terrible. These are liquors that the whole world basically avoids. You have to seek them out because they're that bad. They taste like NyQuil, and they're just way too much alcohol. And we abuse it because we don't do it the way that it's intended. We just shoot it. Mm-hmm. It's disgusting.
And we require a loudmouth soup to make the funny. So here we go, folks. Well, we've got some more...
I love how he has to fucking tell everybody we have a huge following about this ritual. They should know by now. The people that matter should know by now what the fuck we're doing.
Yeah. There's always first-time listeners. First-time listener, first-time caller. Hey, I just want to let you know that I really like the show.
You should moonlight as a baseball announcer. You really should.
Yeah, that's how you can get a little bit outside.
You know what? That's an understaffed profession right now, too. You could go find yourself. It's hard to find somebody that can read and talk.
Fuck stick bat, man. That shit is so boring. All right, well, here, some absinthe. Let's get all sick on it.
Absinthe.
Cheers.
Cheers. Okay,
tastes like somebody took a
shot. Gross liquor.
Tastes like somebody took a piss.
We have the advertisements. What are the advertisements, guys? What do we normally say? Hamtackle, give me one.
Oh, Christ.
Give me one. Where's somewhere the folks should go?
Felcher's Facials?
God damn it, no. We are brought to you by Felcher's Facials, the facial in a flask, folks, by the way. Felcher's Facials.
It's facial in a flask.
Facial in a flask. But no, where should they go? Anybody have anything from the advertisements? Do you remember any of this shit?
Where are we going? PopularIrony.com. I know about PopularIrony.
PopularIrony.com. That's right. Anywhere else they can go?
Sexit, YouTube.
Sexit. We're doing Sexit. It's on YouTube.
You're the one that's got
go to YouTube.
Down.
You can go to Steaming Pile O'Tekit, or you can go to Popular Irony on YouTube. You can also go to PopularIrony.com. While you're at it, you can email us at thebastards@masterbastard.com or contact us on Twitter @masterbastards. Thanks. Why not give it a try?
I do believe if you were to Google Sexit with two X's, we would probably be the only hit.
Probably be the only one for Sexit. And most of our other shows.
Well, actually, there's probably some kind of a...
Drunker Than Lights.
There's a gay porn site that probably links to that you know, you'd be happy to find if you're that kind of guy.
Speaking of the sexy sex, guys, I have a list here. A list of paraphilias.
Oh, God, we gotta go this route already.
Immediately.
We're already in the hot and sexy. Paraphilia, folks,
sexy. That's a good transition from the poop to the sexy.
Well, yeah, there's going to be poop on this list, too, so that's going to tie together.
It's got to be
What's a paraphilia, Hamtackle? I would like to hear your...
Paraphilia?
Yeah.
It's some kind of philia that you get in the Paralympics? I don't know.
Para is probably body, dealing with the body.
This is paraphilia or what all these things are.
I know
it's
that
a sexual attraction, this, you know, an inanimate object or other things, or something that gets people like this just standard.
I know that you have been accused of being a paraphile before.
Paraphile? All these things. Okay, well, we'll start at the very top. The very, very first one at the top in alphabetical order. Abasiophilia.
That's something with the skin, I would think, Basil.
Or abasiophilia. This sounds like one that Hamtackle would be into. It's
cutting faces
being turned
off
on by people with impaired mobility.
Okay. Like scooters.
Basiophilia.
Nothing hotter than a rascal. There's nothing hotter than a rascal.
Or a leg that's, you know.
So give me a letter of the alphabet.
Q.
P.
P was first. We go for the one at the very top. Paraphilic infantilism. Any guys got an idea?
Likes to dress up like a little baby in diapers and get spanked.
Yep. Sexual arousal based on dressing I have or the being internet treated too. Like a baby, also known as atonophilia or and adult baby syndrome.
Extra freaky.
Considerable overlap with diaper fetishism.
Cross-reference.
I think it must have been real sex, because when you're
some
like
kind
you
of
know,
domination too, like S&M, right? There's that part of it. I mean, you spank the baby, don't you?
Well, the baby was bad. I remember it must have been in high school when the only bit of porn you could get before the internet was widespread when we were young was
HBO
Real Sex or something like that, and most of the time it was gross.
Yeah, these are people off the street.
Yeah, you were lucky if you could get one stroke out of
so many old people, saggy boobs. But I remember this one, must have been real sex, where there was like a German grandmother-age woman who had like her an infantilism baby. And it's like a man in his 40s, and she like changes his poopy diapers, and he sucks on a pacifier and has a normal job.
This
is their sexual relationship. It's the thing I kind of get in my mind's eye when I'm
I remember
to
one
off.
Thing when I was 7 years old where this guy.
Well, so the first time I ever heard of infantilism, and it really like was like, ew, like changing a big fat adult German man's diaper. It's like, it was such a dirty baby.
How do you know he just wasn't like severely retarded and you were watching all kinds of worse porn?
All right. Hand tackle. Give me another letter of the alphabet here. Let's see what we got.
Jesus Christ.
Another letter of the alphabet. What you got?
M. He asked me,
F
you motherfucker.
First.
I asked Hamtackle.
Oh, okay. Look at this.
Yeah, can't Bogart
look,
all the
it's two on one, I guess.
Oh, my goodness.
Just
we're
like every other Tuesday.
All right,
the top of M is macrophilia. You guys have any idea what macrophilia is?
Large, fetish for, like, fat people?
Large people? Close. You have a guess
large there? Dildos and large.
Macrophilia, fascination with or a sexual fantasy involving giants.
Wow.
I'm on top of this. What the fuck?
Acromegaly.
Macro. You guys, this ever occur to you guys? Ever have some kind of fetish with like a giant woman,
fuck yeah, I think everybody has that.
I don't know that. I kind of would fear a woman larger than myself. I've not really ever encountered one.
you're a large gentleman, on the plus side of height.
Honestly, I've seen girls like in high school in college where they were like almost as tall or maybe even a little bit taller than me
volleyball
that I played
players,
volleyball.
Yeah.
And it's kind of, I'm telling you, it kind of like catches me off guard a little bit.
It's sexy.
I can like...
It depends. Some of the skeletal structures on some of those big chicks is a little giganticism-y.
Not much.
If she's got like broad shoulders, that could kind of do it for me.
Think about a 6'4" girl. Long tanned ass legs.
6'4" is
Yeah, that
tall.
Is sexy as hell.
I don't know. I'm 6'5", and I don't see any girls anywhere near my height.
In the times
where I encounter men that are taller than me, I instantly can pick them out of a crowd the second I see them because I'm not used to seeing people that are taller than me. So when I do, I notice it right away.
And
if it was a female, I'd be like, what the fuck?
Hamtackle's a natural ability to discern if people are taller than him.
It's natural.
That's a next step in evolution there, man.
It is. No, it's important to size
it
people
looks like
up
that
in case
person
they're going to try to steal all your money like happens to me all the time.
All right. Chapsworth, you want to give me a letter of the alphabet?
F. Let's do F.
F. The very first one of F is feederism. Feederism.
That's F-E-E-D? Or is it?
F-E-D-E-R?
F-E-E-D-E-R-I-S-M.
Okay, so you're like fattening up a chick, like feeding her pork pies?
Erotic eating, feeding, and weight gain. Ding! You're right. You deserve.
I got
a
two out of three, motherfucker.
You win a drink from your Mickey's.
40. I believe that I have to punish somebody else with a drink.
So who brought the Mickey's? Oh yeah, Hamtackle brought Mickey's 40.
Thank
today.
You, bud.
Surprise, surprise.
Oh, that hurt. What the fuck?
Oh,
I was fondling your back.
Yeah.
You know, normally for pleasure, folks, I actually do drink tasty beer, and yeah, so do you guys. We actually drink good beer, but when we get together to record this, we drink the
shittiest, nastiest fucking.
I brought Homs here the other.
That's a couple months ago. Those Homs.
Homs imported.
We recorded a bunch of Drunker Than Light on our YouTube channel and drank a lot of Homs, and it tastes like pea bread.
You know what? It tastes like somebody bottled it in like a fucking oil jug.
That was one of the first glasses I owned as a kid. That I like bought.
Your sippy cup was Homs?
Well, no, it was a chalice, a glass chalice that just said Homs across
really?
The
Really?
Yeah, it was
really they make chalices?
It was a chalice.
At work, I think I tweeted about this, but I was at work, and I walked by a woman's desk, and she had like a child's sippy cup with a little like the spout thing on there, and she was drinking out of it. And it creeped me out to such a level of just like uncomfortableness, just...
Did she really mouth the thing when she drank?
Well, it's just like, and she used two hands too and tipped her head back a bunch. Like, no, she didn't. But it was, I don't know why, just her drinking out of a sippy cup. And she's an attractive woman without any disabilities. There's no reason for her to drinking out of a toddler's.
Maybe she's scared of it spilling onto her computer.
She's terrified.
I work with a guy with baby arms, and it's weird to see him drink.
Like Tyrannosaurus chair arms?
Yes. Yeah, like Tyrannosaurus arms, you know, like backwards facing, kind of messed up kind of little arms. No, he's a cool guy and everything. I'm totally not afraid of him. I fucking
high-five
him.
Is he a thalamide, dude?
Dude, I don't know what the nomenclature would refer to him.
It was what they used to give people in the 50s. We've talked about this. The little baby stump arm things. Was it like that? Or is it
he had little baby stump arms. Yeah, he had the whole full-on genetic.
Little pterodactyl arms and shit. I love it.
Yeah, he's a cool guy. I mean, and I'm not afraid of it at all. Like, I totally high-five him and everything.
Is his hand creepy and gnarly and nubby?
He gives a good high-five. It's a little thumping high five is what we get. So, yeah, but I mean, I did, you know, it's just weird to see him, like, pick up a water bottle and unscrew it and then, like, sort of have to shift his whole body weight and sort of shovel it. It's sad. I'm not saying anything wrong.
Extra long straws for him.
I like to be supportive of people with disabilities. I don't want to, like, you know.
I cheer him on.
I know, but I go to this one store, this popular shopping store place where you buy things. And there's this guy there who's in a wheelchair, has no legs, and one arm with little stubby, nubby fingers on it. And the other hand is just like a finger on the end of a stick, kind of.
But he could probably do all kinds of shit with that nub.
Well, I've tried to not interfere and stuff, and I got a jug of milk, and it's rolling down the thing, and I'm like just thinking, this guy can handle it, he's all cool, and he like grabs the milk, and he's struggling, and his finger's bending back, and he goes, ah, and I grab it and set it over, like, I'm sorry. I felt bad.
Well, I told you about that little skinny Asian guy that I sort of work with, and he left like a little box that, like, IT came through and put a box down that had like computer parts in it. It's like a little one of those like paper crate boxes, like just, you know, a box of paper reams, right?
Yeah.
And he's got just the parts. He left it there in his aisle, and he comes up to me. He goes, "Hey man, can you give me a hand?" I said, "What? Sure." He goes, "Could you move that box?" And I thought, what does he think? I'm some just fucking guy that you can just order out? Oh, he can't pick it up. I didn't even cross my mind, but I was thinking, man, you know what? It is kind of moved out of the center of the aisle. Maybe he's been pushing it around for about 5 minutes. Yeah,
struggling with it the entire time.
Yeah, you shake his hand and like his whole body waves. He's so frail and small. But yeah, that's when I realized he couldn't actually pick up the little box, and he was probably kind of sad about it.
Aww.
And you took it as a challenge. He was challenging you.
Well, at first that's what I thought. I thought he was like, he's fucking ordering me around to like pick shit up.
You're a hero.
Well, I just thought he called me all the way over to his section to tell me that there's computer parts laying out.
Maybe he feels comfortable with you.
And I thought, well, he's just telling me. Oh,
maybe he just wanted to get you alone. This was like, you know, he was testing the waters.
Oh, so he took me into
you
his
big strong
world
man. Can you pick this up for me? Oh, you're so big and tough.
Took me into his roll full of people. Yeah,
he's a supervisor. He just was like, he just didn't want to, you know, be seen probably struggling with it anymore in the public. I think it's really where it came down.
Stop real quick. We need to scoot over a little bit. I'm watching this, and you're picking up fine, and, except for when you're facing him, and you're really small because it's like right in front of.
All right, one, two, three.
No. At least you just need to scoot down, and you need to scoot down.
Okay.
I apologize.
Cut. Yeah. Cut, everybody. Everybody, I'd like to engineer a little bit better experience for the listener.
It's nice to be so close to you now. We were kind of drifting farther away.
Okay, this is where I'm going to talk, and I'm going to talk like this every single goddamn time.
That's fine. That's a lot better.
Fuck that.
It's much better.
I'm
talking
you're
not like forward like that, but now we're all kind of equidistant from it as far as our heads.
We were before.
No, you were way... Your waveform was tiny.
Dude, my waveform is just not stacking up to everybody else's waveform.
Your waveform isn't cutting it, man.
Totally.
You guys got to start editing then, because it makes me sad inside.
Okay,
you
next.
Need to start recording so that we don't fucking just sit here for 5 minutes doing nothing.
It's still recording. All right.
You need to include all that shit.
What?
You need to include some of that little argument we just had.
We'll try.
He won't. He feels too self-conscious.
God damn it.
Too self-conscious.
Okay.
Anybody that's ever met him knows exactly how self-conscious.
What did you say?
Be.
You can make him feel absolutely.
Well, no. I just criticized something that he would put on the stereo as a joke, and he immediately just apologized.
Show you something, and you're like, if it's a goddamn podcast, I'm going to blow my fucking head off. I'm like, okay, well, I'm not going to put this on then because it wasn't part of a podcast.
It was. That's a little bit of an exaggeration.
You're almost guilty of being too good of a host sometimes.
I like
you felt
friends.
All bad about it, and then you're like putting on a YouTube video, and I don't say anything. I'm just sitting there, and it goes for about 2 minutes, and you turned and looked at me and said,
I'm so sorry about this, dude.
This is not...
It wasn't funny.
This isn't what I thought it was going to be, man.
It wasn't funny.
Immediately
that actually was hilarious.
All right, getting back.
Whose turn is
it? His.
Hamtackle.
How about yours? What, why don't you choose?
Well, I don't... Because I haven't read this over yet, so go ahead and give me one. I'll take a... T. See if I can guess it. T. There's three pages, and it's alphabetical, so if you're not seeing it with the A's, it's probably a couple pages down.
Shut up.
A couple pages down.
I know what I'm looking for.
You have the best personality for a supervisor, too. I just wanted to point that out.
You have no idea what a fucking little bitch I am in that environment.
You are a bitch.
I put up with so many people's fucking just making little excuses and bullshit, and I, you know, don't outright accuse them, but I just hold them accountable, and that's it. Like, I fucking hate them. All of them. Like, everything.
Like you. It's just like I hate you and everybody else around me ever.
Oh, that was fun.
Raptophilia.
Raptophilia? Is that a...
Raptophilia.
With fetish of birds of prey? Like, birds of prey?
R. Raptophilia.
Spell it.
No.
Just fucking spell it.
Use your fucking imagination.
R-A-P-T-O-philia? Rapt?
Rapto... Yeah, hold on a second. Fuck's sake.
God damn it.
We just can't guess. We got to raptophilia.
Well, it has to be like a spelling bee.
Raptophilia. For fuck's sake, I'm not repeating it.
I'm sorry that made.
All I can think of is a bird of prey. I have no idea what it's wrapped up to be.
Just make a fuck.
I have no idea.
God damn it! Just tell me what it is.
Raptophilia. Raptophilia is committing rape, possibly consensual rape fantasies.
Whoa. I said T, by the way, not R. Yeah, so, but you went to rape anyway.
Yeah, it's immediate.
It's like, good. Why don't you pick hashtag one out? Rape culture.
How about piquerism? P-I-Q-U-E-R-I-S-M.
Piquerism.
Piquerism.
Is that like fetish of tiny people?
No, sir.
I don't know.
You don't know. You can't even. You don't even have the fucking
toes and toes fingers.
Sexual gratification through the penetration of another person, most commonly by stabbing or cutting the body with sharp objects.
So you fuck an open wound?
Oh!
That's prison sex,
baby!
You come by, like, stabbing people.
Oh, okay.
Oh, not by fucking the stab wound. That's the way I understood
that's
it, too.
What I thought, yeah.
Maybe it does say sexual gratification through penetration.
Yeah!
By stabbing or cutting the body with sharp objects.
It could just be boning a wound, too.
I know, but it could be boning a wound. Let's pretend it's boning a wound, because that sounds a whole lot better.
You could make a stretch to, like, fucking an armpit, or, you know, taking an earlobe
you
flat.
You could carve out a hole in a calf and poke it through, too.
Piece of liver.
Oh, this
microwave
is a sad
liver.
One. As long as the other person is willing and participating, go ahead and poke a hole in me and stuff your cum in there. Sounds great. Stuff your dirty dick in my seething wound.
Immediate MRSA fucking infection.
Oh, dude, there's some horrible MRSA.
Are you just reading all the lists? We're supposed to just go over a bunch of those and not like
okay,
not,
your
like,
turn.
Read them all.
You almost gave me a paper cut. I would never have forgave you.
You played the game wrong.
Okay,
there's no game.
Pick a letter, dick fuck.
You're gonna go fuck yourself. It's what's gonna happen.
Okay, let's drink first. Cheers, ladies.
Oh.
Thanks for listening, folks.
Drinking Mickey's Horties, these are really gross.
Yeah, it's warm now, too, because you fucking let it sit out for 37 minutes.
I wonder why, because somebody fucking fell asleep and was like, oh, right now how we're supposed to be there? Yeah, I kind of just woke up.
No, I got a text message saying that your dumbass was on your way an hour before we were the scheduled meeting time.
And you were sleeping.
I fell asleep, yeah, and I woke up at 5:38.
So, because I sent you a reminder an hour before than the normal time, you fell asleep?
Letting you know he
was leaving early, and then maybe if you wanted to, you could show up early, so you fell asleep.
No,
I don't understand the logic.
I woke up to this text, like, oh, fuck. Because my phone is on vibrate constantly.
Chapsworth lives about a half hour away from me, and so does Hamtackle. They're about equidistant in the opposite direction. So I'm like the center point of this
you're like
trifecta
the,
of friendship.
You're Pierre in the Lucky Pierre.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I'm sent the
code for that.
Middleman in a three-way bang.
Suspender down. One suspender down, by the way.
Really? I thought that was for
skin. We were all supposed to get together at 6 o'clock.
Red suspender with
6
white
o'clock
shirt.
For early evening drinking. 6 o'clock.
I was 7 minutes late.
Hamtack,
8 minutes late.
You were 27 minutes late.
No, I was not.
You called and said you woke up at like 5:55.
Do you want to know when I called you exactly?
Yeah, I did tell you to drive recklessly to get here,
and
you
got
pretty quick.
Yeah,
you still got here.
I got here.
You drove like you had the laser still.
Just moments before you called, we were joking that how late is he going to be?
You're always
late. I put you guys out.
You're always late.
You know, I didn't know it was supposed. I was supposed to be here right on time.
Maybe
for something we're not going to fucking start until 45.
You know, maybe sometimes we just
anyway.
Need to hold you to task, and maybe you're responsible for when you get here.
All right, pick it. Pick something. Fuck both of you. Pick something. You can suck two dicks, man.
Been there.
You've already read this shit. Biastophilia.
Biastophilia?
B-I-A-S.
Biastophilia.
Biastophilia?
Bias.
So, you'll get off on chicks with two asses.
Think about bias.
Yeah, I'm thinking some kind of, you know.
Your fantasy. Your fucking whole culture revolves around this.
Okay, now I want to hear what it is, and I'm not guessing because it'll sound horrible.
Violence?
It's rape of an unconsenting person.
Jesus!
See also consensual rape fantasy.
We already went through that. Yeah. What was raptophilia?
It was the only B on the list. You picked, not Dick.
Oh. Q.
Oh, Q. Q.
There is no Q, please.
Oh, yeah, I win the game.
All right.
We know I win the game.
You guys want to have another delicious taste of this disgusting liquor?
No, yes, we do need to.
Let's pick two more.
No, no. You pick one. Tell us what it is, for fuck's sake.
No, you guys pick.
You've got an eye on it. You know you're waiting for it.
Excuse me. Troilism.
Troilism?
Yeah.
You will get off on dead Greek cities. Dead Macedonian cities.
Cuckoldism.
Watching one's wife get banged. I've seen cuckold videos before. They gross me out.
Oh, I love them. It's always like it's some old, like bald white guy and some big giant.
Well, because sometimes I'll search I'm in my 30s. Housewife and MILF tends to be like around the same age level. So sometimes I will search in the porn engine for housewife or MILF. And 90% of the time it's
AKA
housewife cuckold. Big black berry banging your wife while you watch and cry. Like, this isn't sexy.
I think we know that you're searching jailbait and Lolita.
Yeah, I've noticed that my porn searching has really changed over the years.
Like, well, it used to just be teens. It
got younger and younger.
It used to just be tits.
Oh.
That's all I care. Now I want a big ass. And it's got to be anal.
It's got to be anal?
It has to be.
Yeah, I'm not satisfied unless a woman's bleeding.
Well, no. No, the bouncing. I have to have that big bouncing fat ass staring me at the
You guys ever watch them cream pie videos?
Oh, yeah. Just like gangbang cream pies where she like takes it all in the butt and then she shits it all out into a wine glass.
And drinks it. Okay, last one.
Jesus Christ.
That's exactly
folks,
what I need now.
You can email us at themasterbastard.com.
Tell us about your fetish.
Tell us about your multiple cream pies.
This is the last one.
Shitting in
You're all agnia. You're all Asia.
Water sports, peeing on your partner.
Yep. You've read this.
Oh, fuck
yeah. He's searched it so many times in Google.
Particularly in public.
Dude, I know. I got like.
And or being urinated.
I got like
on,
three
also
out of
referred
four.
To as water sports.
Water sports.
Golden showers.
We can't end on that one. We
yeah, we
can. On
we just
one.
Did.
One where it stumps
we just
your
did.
Dumb ass.
We can come back to it later.
We can.
One more. Just
Don't
one more.
Don't feel out of luck here.
That one's. Clismophilia.
K.
K-L-I-S. Maphilia. M-A. Clismaphilia.
Sweaty Betty.
This one is particularly good for you.
All are, apparently. What the fuck?
Not your fat ass.
Okay.
This other one is enemas, either giving or having.
Enemas.
Giving or having enemas?
Clis. K with a K. Read it. Clismaphilia.
Here you go.
Enemas, either giving or having. Infantophilia, pedophilia with a focus on children 5 years old or younger. God damn it. If.
Oh, it's what?
It's just a picture. It's not an app or anything.
Slimy rectum pirate.
Slimy rectum pirate?
Pick a number between 1 and 20.
So, 20. I heard something funny. Gravy is like meat. Is gravy's like meat lotion?
Because gravy's like meat. And, okay, another time, 1 out of 20.
13.
Okay, and one more. One out of 20.
One.
Creepy crotch pilot.
Great. Are you looking at something that generates random list of stupid names for the ultimate insult creator?
It's not really insulting.
Pick one in each column.
Butterface crotch jockey, pie-eating boner monster, lazy turd knob, smelly cock knob, pie-eating prick goblin,
It's a lot of pie.
Pie eating.
Ugly bitch box. Why is Nob listed a couple times here? Stupid ass canoe. Smelly shit box. Creepy shart waffle.
Nice. Well, there you go. That's the end of that.
The ultimate insult creator. Yeah,
that went quick.
Hey guys, what's this?
That's something you bought earlier.
I bought. I don't know
what's
why.
What's this? What's
Oh, we're going to have some... Oh, okay. We'll have another shot, folks, because I think we haven't drank it.
Nobody does. That's the whole point.
This shit is so
nobody wants another shot of this, so fucking just sit down and do it.
I don't want to drink this Mickey's, but I'm going to finish it.
Did you see the fantasy name that I put up?
No, for our fantasy football league?
Uh-huh.
What is your fantasy name?
I'm not telling you until you read it.
Thanks for telling the people the punchline.
It's sex balls.
Is it really? Fucking idiot.
Sorry.
Oh, I breathed it way too fast. So it's my real name sucks balls.
Yes.
That's funny.
I just thought it.
Way to be creative.
I liked it. It was specific towards you.
It's great. It's great. Now everybody's going to think we're dating again.
Ah! Ah!
You know what mine is? It's the Hungry Penguins, because we call them some of the really, really, really big people.
It's good
penguins.
Stuff.
Work because we're polite gentlemen. I'm a big man.
Oh, so you're making fun of the fat people with your name.
I'm a fat guy too, but there's the people who are a lot fatter than me, and so I might as well, you know, try to make myself feel better.
Well,
before we,
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to drop your. No. I didn't even think.
Oh,
about it.
Stop talking about it. It just makes me sad.
Now he just has to do more edits. You understand?
Yeah.
He doesn't want us to break the third wall and talk about him editing.
Oh, I don't mind that. I'm a terrible editor. There's a hum I can't get out of it. I try, but that hum doesn't go away. You hear that hum, folks? Listen. I hate it.
It's your refrigerator.
Yeah, it's your... Yeah, you've got something going on.
Maybe no,
you
just left the cacophonous of the room. I didn't even hang up the blankets this week.
The cacophonous?
The cacophony? The cacophony?
The cacophony.
Anyway.
Onomatopoeia?
Cacophony.
What did you buy earlier today?
So we always torture ourselves on this show and with like terrible drinks, terrible foods, those disgusting sodas from last time. And for some reason today, sorry, I apologize, that was really meaty. I went to a tobacco store and bought a tin of snuff, because as you know, folks, we are a classy motherfucker.
They have snuff still?
I was shocked, too.
That's not the kind of snuff I look up.
I didn't think so. Yeah, that poor hooker getting the nail gun to the back of the neck.
Oh, come on, she deserved it, you know. Oh, watch it, you'll know.
Thanks. So, yeah, this is actually me committing insurance fraud, truthfully.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
I probably shouldn't actually do this at all, should I? Because I have signed a contract at work with my insurance that you can't do any tobacco products or you lose your insurance.
It's consistent use of tobacco.
Oh, snuff. So snuff, folks. What is snuff there, chaps?
Snuff is just ground up fucking...
Ground
tobacco,
up, yeah,
man.
Just delicious.
That's
if you've
powder.
Ever seen a movie that takes place in the 18th or 17th century, there's foppish men with powdered wigs.
Foppish.
Taking little bits of snuff and sneezing.
I think it's sort of like cigarette cocaine.
This is original snuff by Silver Dollar. Warning, smokeless tobacco is addictive. Smokeless tobacco is addictive.
I gotta say, though, it comes in this little tin here with, like, an old-timey silver dollar on it.
Because it's the size almost of its own.
Yeah, I see that now. That was a good idea to have it open, too.
I didn't think you'd grab it and start dumping it.
No.
So, folks, snuff is a form of finely ground smokeless tobacco predominantly enjoyed by the English aristocracy of the 18th century. It is arguably healthier alternative to smoking for the user.
It's almost
it's
like you printed this out
when I've
read.
Had Alps in them.
You cut me off.
This is from wikihow.com.
I was
because okay, I didn't know how to do snuff.
What is the main? Who's the main person that would buy this? Who's the person? That
pedophiles, mostly pedophiles,
say,
as evidenced by the person who bought this.
Rowan Atkinson in one of the Blackadder episodes.
I gotta say though, the packaging is not very contemporary. That looks like you probably stole it.
It
out
looks
of,
like a shoe shine little tin.
Oh, there was a shitload of flavors too. There was a whole bunch of different berry flavors and everything else. I just got original.
Finish, please.
But here, I got all the steps of how to take snuff, guys, if you're curious. But you guys want to try
it? Imagine it comes with us snorting it, probably, if you take
I think
it
a little dose and you snort it, but I thought we'd make it official and try
okay,
to
read it.
Step one.
What's on your knuckles there on your left hand?
That's snuff that I dumped all over my hands. I tipped after I yelled at Hamtackle for turning it upside down. I dumped it all over my crotch.
Did you watch that
and
shit?
And shirt. I don't even know if it still has snuff in it, truthfully, after I turned it upside down.
Dude, right, you only need a little bit.
We need a mirror.
How do you snuff? The first step in how do you snuff? Okay. Any guesses?
You put it on a mirror.
Purchase a tin of snuff.
Oh, fuck. That's good marketing, is what that is.
Make sure you're indoors or in a very well-sheltered area, and take out your snuff tin.
No wind.
Yeah, you can't
win.
Then
you take the snuff.
Put it right here, I'm guessing. Right on your...
Yep. Right on the crook of your thumb and forefinger.
Yeah, like, so you can put it on with a little divot between your thumb and wrist.
Or you can cut a pen.
Or you take a pinch in your fingers and sniff it. So this is like another way of taking tobacco. You just snort it in your nose. This is terrible.
Let's do a line.
Fuck you!
Like a rail.
I don't know why I did this. We torture ourselves with disgusting things.
Let's do a gator line or nothing at all.
I'm not. You can fucking do all the lines you want. I am not doing the fucking line of snuff.
I'm not even...
You're supposed to torture yourself. You're not supposed to actually get it up inside, like way up in your inside.
I thought we were supposed to torture ourselves.
I'm not taking it.
Steph, why not?
Because I don't want any tobacco. That's gross.
It's coming from a two-pack-a-day smoker.
Exactly. It's been a long time. I don't want to necessarily start getting any tobacco.
It's
going to
be like a meth head, just like, ah, I got the taste of my blood.
I don't want
again.
Tobacco, and I don't want to snort it for fun.
This
sake.
Would trigger it?
No, I'm not saying it would trigger it.
I'm saying it would be incredibly unpleasant.
Maybe I can appreciate this.
No shit. That's the whole point.
You brought over a ghost chili pepper and had us all taste it.
That's not all I brought over.
You should.
Do you have something that could match snuff?
I think we could we could take my challenge along with your challenge, and maybe I might do a little bit.
Okay, what's your challenge?
Well, okay. If you got something to bring to the table that's better than a disgusting small tin of snuff, I hate tobacco. Pickles.
Pickles? You like pickles?
I saw this earlier, folks. He showed it to me, and I hid it in the jar where I had a bunch of in the cabin where I put a bunch of pickles.
Oh, what is this? This is pickled something.
There you go. Chapsworth, what is that can?
Gefilte fish? What are we, Jewish now?
How big is that can?
This is the Master Bastard's Multicultural Adventure.
Master Bastard Multicultural Adventure.
Rock
each. Can you explain everything on there?
This is a can of Rock Each brand. I don't know. I've never... It is a delicious sweet recipe. Friends and family since 1870.
Oh, gefilte fish, folks.
Old Vienna gefilte fish. Now, here's one thing I would like to point out about this. First off, this is a can, and it is ready to serve. Ready to serve, gentlemen.
Oh, so I can eat it right out of there with a big fucking wooden spoon.
Not only,
fucking hobo.
Not only like, can you, it's expected.
I've never had gefilte fish.
Oh, my God.
Okay, hold on.
You're ready to start gagging, dude.
It may be used for Passover and all year round. Now, here's the thing. It's nutritional facts in the back, right? They have two sets of nutritional facts. One is the fish only. The other column is fish with 4 tablespoons jelly. Which is considerably more sodium, so I think we might want to get some of the jelly.
We need to wash it.
All right, I need to take a picture of that before we open it, because that's going to be the picture of the week.
Okay, it does say ingredients are water, carp, white fish, egg whites, sugar, mullet,
fish,
salt, matzo meal.
It's like all matzo the stinkiest fishiest
fishes.
Have you
ever had matzo balls?
This is going to be my first.
Matzo's delicious. Fine, but when you get all the fishes, that really encapsulate the
fish
smell.
Think about
that
fish sweet with the texture of jelly.
Gross.
That's not all. Onion, pike.
Oh, some pike.
Monosodium glutamate, MSG.
Oh, a little MSG.
Hey,
yeah,
all right.
That's good.
Xanthan gum.
Even sweeter.
Carob seed gum. Pepper and natural flavorings. These extra-large home-style portions are excellent as a main course or appetizer. Serve either hot or cold. Ready to eat.
Gefilte fish.
Ready to eat, gentlemen. Here, hold on. Let me go ahead real quick, though, before we... Let me
just
go ahead.
Just hold that against your chest, bro.
That's what it sounds like.
That's a can of gefilte fish.
That's some sloshing fish. Would you mind holding it right here on your body there?
I'm not going to do that.
Because I know I'll hold, or just right like that. I'll take the little one. Just hold it there. I just need some goddamn light on it. Old Vienna gefilte... Oh, come on. Trying to take a picture and he's moving it all over the place. That looks disgusting.
It's going to be.
All right, let's get this open.
Well, there's a can opener probably right behind you in that drawer right there.
It's okay, thanks for that. It's not electric, so
we're really...
So we went from
almost taking a dose of snuff and sneezing our heads off. Now we're going to go from sneezing our heads off to throwing up uncontrollably.
Oh,
we got
a can
of fucking translucent fish. There's carp in there mixed with oil.
I don't know. It looks pretty appetizing on the preparation on the can.
How does it look on the can?
It's a pale...
It looks like it's got some boiled red cabbage with a slice of carrot on top of that disgusting-looking fish. Oh, delicious.
Can't open them.
There's
can't
four pieces. Oh, I wish Ramtang was here. There's four pieces.
I know. It's kind of sad. You know what? We'll hold on to some for him. It can stay in a in fridge.
It's going to be fun.
Oh, it did squeal a little with a little bit of air release once I
cut it. The can opener is opening the can of Rockich.
We need to make this a fish. Oh, can you smell it?
Ooh.
I don't want to breathe it. Gefilte fish
this
from
is
Yiddish.
A specialty.
It's
oh, yeah.
an Ashkenazi
Jewish
mixture of ground boned fish such as carp, whitefish, or pike. Which
it's
is
actually, it's not bad. I've had it before. It's not bad at
it
all.
It smells like Dinty Moore beef stew. Uh-huh. It smells like Dinty Moore beef stew. Which pretty much means, folks, it smells
oh
like
oh, my
alcohol.
God.
Oh, there's so much jelly on it. It looks like fish Salisbury steak. Oh, thank you. He gave me a slice like it's a piece of pie.
Oh my god, it's holding up a fork.
Oh.
Oh, it quivers. It quivers.
It's not bad.
You got oh my god. Oh, it
Look
cuts
at the jelly.
Easily.
Look at that jelly
it
there.
Cuts
you
really
need to get
it
some of
it. Reminds me exactly of a microwavable Salisbury steak made of fish.
In order.
No, no jelly.
No, you really need the jelly.
Oh
no
my god,
jelly.
It smells so bad.
There's no jelly.
Some of that.
No jelly.
Shut that jelly. It looks like it's not on his plate. Yes. I don't want
any flashy. No, you have
some.
To.
You have to.
Oh my god.
The jelly is part of the ritual.
Oh, where's the jelly?
You need to get it.
Oh my god, it's so thick.
Trying to get it on a fork
is not
easy.
You need to get some of that brine.
Look at the snot.
Look at that. See? Come on, guys.
I don't think I can do it.
Yeah, you can.
Oh, I'm gagging already.
Pour some of the brine on there.
Oh, I've already got jelly.
Chapsworth is eating it.
I mean, just jelly.
You're eating just jelly? That's the grossest thing I've ever seen.
Oh,
it's like chipped.
That jelly's got a chew to it.
Okay, I'm taking a bite.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay, it's not that bad at all.
Oh my god, it is so.
It's
get
gross.
Some of the jelly.
It's gross, but it's not
I'm
like
not eating gonna, that shit.
It's not like I'm gonna puke. I don't want to eat anymore.
You gotta finish that.
I'm not gonna
life.
Fuck you! Fuck don't. You! We're taking shots of absinthe and drinking Mickey's. I'm not gonna eat a whole piece of gefilte fish.
How much was that can?
Oh.
My eyes are watering to keep me from throwing up right now.
Oh, it's so gross.
I had a bite of that. That's all that happened. It's all that happened. I had a fork of phlegm and a decent-sized chunk of cat food. I'm not eating anymore.
Oh, my God. It tastes like what I think cat food tastes like. That's exactly
it's
it.
It's like chipped
it's cat
fish.
Food. That's fucking cat food.
Chipped fish is what it's
I
like
can't even make. Look at it anymore. That's
whatever. You guys are bitches.
That is so fucking gross.
Whatever.
Well, you're even uncircumcised. How is this going down?
Oh,
easily.
Oh. Okay, I'm going to scrape it back into this.
Extra snotty because of the jelly.
Chaps, would you mind getting this
gone.
Shit away from us?
I want it gone.
I'm going to put... I just... Let me just put this down the garbage disposal.
No, I'm going to put it
for
in the trash.
For fuck's sake,
no.
Nope. You need to have some phlegm.
I have some phlegm. It's disgusting.
No, you didn't.
It's got a strong flavor. Ooh, it's got a strong flavor. That's going to make my beer taste terrible for a 2 days.
Oh, man, it is really... It's worse now than it was when I first tasted it.
When I chewed it and that texture...
Oh, there's so much jelly at the bottom.
Oh, damn it, we're wasting all the delicious fish jelly.
When I fucking bit into that and it just gave like
there
it was made of wet sawdust. Oh, my goodness.
That was really bad. Thank you for bringing
gross.
That, Hamtackle. You know what I could use after that is a nice little bit of...
snuff to watch it.
Silver dollar snuff. I really actually don't. I don't know why I did this. This
here,
terrible.
let me just get it over with.
Oh, Hamtackle's doing a dose. He put a little sprinkle
a little
on the. Oh, that's a lot.
That's way too much, man. You're gonna hurt yourself there. There you go.
Okay, there's a little dusting.
A little sniff. How is it? What's it like?
Can you give me a little room here to get in? Things?
You look really classy.
It's
kind of
burning.
You remind me of a.
Yeah,
you
it burns
know,
for a little
foppish.
Bit.
You look excessively foppish.
It's got a smell to it.
This is original.
It's actually quite pleasant, but the stinging fucking takes
it's
away
not
from
that
the
bad.
Pleasant.
It doesn't make me. I have decent sinuses. You have terrible sinuses, so I don't know.
I have
know
terrible
why.
Sinuses too. This is a mistake.
I have terrible sinuses from doing illicit drugs for, you know, a little while.
Oh, you were into the drugs? Gross.
I never touch it.
Yeah, never.
Ah, so there's burning and there's glistening of snot. It's like my ha ha.
Yeah, it's gross, and I'm not a big fan of tobacco anymore. I've smoked way too much in my youth. like two packs a day of Reds.
It's
for
not bad. It's like snorting fucking alfalfa and then sneezing.
That's what it's like. Right?
It smells just like alfalfa. That's exactly it. That was a mistake. Oh, that's
gross. Oh, holy shit.
What's the matter?
It's a huge bump there,
Jesus
buddy.
Jesus Christ.
It came out that way.
And you're... Damn, Chaps, that's a lot of snuff.
What, man? You guys are fucking ridiculous. It's not that
You
much.
Told him to get rid of, like, half that dose.
I've done this before. I'm not scared.
Well, show us how big of a dick you have.
Wow, you should just take this with you if you want it, because I definitely don't want to keep it.
Yeah, and you actually use tobacco on a regular basis, so...
I don't. This is the first tobacco I've had in
get it,
years.
Get it?
I'm smelling it.
I know. That's how you use it.
Oh, this was a mistake. Gefilte fish and snuff, folks. You know, next I got a gun. What were we talking about earlier? You got a...
Oh, yeah, I was going to bring over my .357 Magnum, and I was going to cock it back, and we were going to play catch with it until somebody got shot.
Or it just goes off. Just a cock .357. I think that's our next best choice here. We got
the
fish.
But the strategy of that game is you throw it in a way that is going to get the other guy shot.
Oh.
So you, like, twirl it in the air. Sort of.
It catches their finger. And
yeah, so they grab for it, they accidentally shoot themselves.
I was thinking about buying a gun recently.
You really? Are you thinking of
I have plenty.
Checking out?
But yeah, I'm tired of this shit. Fuck you guys. No, just, you know, to be cool. You guys were talking about it a couple years ago.
Yeah, I got
you
a lot
got
of guns.
You got a fucking pretty badass gun. Couple
Come visit me, folks. I got a lot of guns.
Yeah, a lot of guns. We're Merca. Merca!
You know, and to be able to go to the shooting range with both of you douchebags would be
yeah,
kind of fun.
Yeah, it's been a long time. Man, I've shot my .357 twice now.
Damn.
Yeah. But the fucking prices of them are out of this world. I'd rather buy, like,
it is
a fish tank.
It is about a dollar.
You know,
it's
take
like
my car off and shit like
it's
that.
It's like a dollar a bullet to shoot my Magnum. Yeah. A little over.
Wow. But I have guns that, you know, will be willed to me, but I haven't shot them for...
You just gotta wait for your dad to die.
Like, 15 years, you know?
God damn it.
Oh, that's actually sinus clearing and kind of nice, because I've had fucking
oh, man.
Horrible allergies
around, like,
all week.
He's going to stop chewing and start snuffing.
No.
Yeah, and then I can only
that
imagine...
cleared my sinus.
I can only imagine mistake. Doing this would get you arrested on the street. Like, cops would be like, what the fuck are you doing?
How many people have you seen ever do snuff before?
Never.
I know, except
it's
in Charlie Chaplin
It's always
Chaplin
like
films.
For shock value, ugh. Usually.
I bet
just Charlie Chaplin
oh, I bet you anything within the next year, hipsters are going to be all over it in the next craze.
Oh, my
probably.
God.
Thick frame glasses and suspenders.
There will be like a cloves version.
Ooh.
There was cloves. There was ugh. They had a lot of flavors.
Remember smoking those in our youth? Those
your
were
cloves.
Fucking horrible.
You ever have beedies?
Beedies, yep. Those little Indian ugh, leaf wrap cigarettes. Ugh. I used to smoke those.
They're hard to keep lit, but they fucking burn you up with tobacco and fucking nicotine, dude. Those things are crazy.
Yeah, I used to smoke those.
Nasty.
Oh, that gefilte fish is fucking making me
it's
hot.
It's creeping up on
me. It's not so bad. I'll fucking eat the whole thing. Yeah, let's go.
I think
on,
it might be the mix of this gefilte fish or gefilte fish. And,
we need to take a week off of hurting ourselves on this show.
I don't know. Go. Next time, I almost, you know what? This time, I almost bought some 5-hour energies and some NyQuil and some vodka.
Oh,
we
no.
We should do that one day.
Yeah, we're going to do it.
We are.
The knife fight? You're going to make the knife
we're
fight?
Gonna, we're going to have a knife fight here in the fucking podcast.
Oh, we shouldn't be drinking NyQuil.
You,
nobody
fucking,
should drink NyQuil recreationally.
I know, that's why we're going to
do you think it's do you
nobody
think that's
should,
any less fucking bad than what we're drinking here?
Absinthe?
Oh my god, that's even worse.
At least this is intended just to be drank casually instead of like...
So was NyQuil.
So was a knife fight.
So was a knife fight. Oh, what kind of vodka? Are you going for McCormick?
Yeah, we have
the
to
plastic
do
jug?
Skull.
Yeah, top of.
Just Skull.
We should
you
know, do. We Skull should do.
The, Skull's the only vodka on the bottle that says charcoal filtered, kinda.
You know what?
Yeah, kinda.
I will buy a small like 750 or 375 of Belvedere for that. So we don't.
Why
have
would
to,
we not go for the cheapest?
Because that's the worst.
Fuck
awful
that!
Shit.
No, man. If we're gonna,
I think we should
if
do
we're
Belvedere.
Gonna ruin some vodka, let's not make.
It won't
privacy.
Ruin it. Are you kidding me? Can you?
You're mixing it with 5-hour energy and NyQuil.
Do you remember when we were in Ireland and we put our hat, our fucking cast our shit in the hat to get the possible, like, what was it, a 30-year
yeah.
Jameson that they had that was like a $3,000 bottle or something mm-hmm. that they had on display that was all like crazy?
That wouldn't have been awesome.
Didn't fucking win.
We would have drank that
you
that
didn't?
Night.
No
probably.
Way.
We would have drank it that night and not appreciated it.
Oh, I would have just drank the whole fucking thing without a chaser and just breathing through my nose the whole time. Just drinking it.
Oh. Oh yeah.
See, you love that shit. I can't stand it.
Well, that I would.
Hamtackle requires liquor to be able to go to sleep without crying.
No, to go to sleep at all, my friend. I have had.
Crying.
I don't know if people know this shit on here. Sleazy. I've not really talked about it, but I don't sleep very much at all. Like, I'm not a good sleeper.
Let's talk about your insomnia.
I fucking the other night, two nights ago. Remember when I when we got back on Payday on Xbox?
We're playing Payday 2 on Xbox, folks. Pick it up now, Payday 2.
I had like an extra 3 levels on you. That's because I spent 3.5 hours playing with random people on the internet.
You played with random
strangers on the internet.
You don't even talk to strangers outside of your house.
What is wrong?
And then until 5:30 in the morning, in which I went, took a shower, and went to work.
Wow, that triggers like the illicit drug.
And it's not because I'm up all night. I didn't stay up because I was playing the game. I went to bed, tried to sleep, gave up, got up, and played video.
Do you have that sense of dread? When that happens, I remember that sense of dread
I have felt that sense of dread before, but I'm so used to it now.
Really?
I mean, I probably...
I don't think I could.
I probably spend 2 or 3 nights a month completely sleepless. Damn. Every single month. Completely
sleepless. And you function great in work.
I would even... I could even drink and you know, get drunk and stay up all night and then go to work.
I can't imagine that. Can you imagine that?
That sounds terrible.
And I manage people.
Sounds like hell.
I meet
is
with
it
people
because
all day long.
Of your job that this has
no.
been.
It's because it's. I've had problems sleeping since I was 15.
In college, you seem to sleep just fine.
You know, but we made a lot of efforts to make ourselves tired in college.
Yeah,
like,
sure
we went through a lot for that.
For example,
but I still well.
I just saw a woman set something on my front porch through the.
Is it a dildo? Let's see. I bet it's a dildo.
You guys carry on the conversation while I solve this mystery.
It's a dog shit.
So
or a dildo.
It was most.
In high school, even, like, I didn't sleep hardly at all, even though I had a job, I went to school, and I played football, all three of those things, I still would
you weren't
only
tired
sleep
enough.
4 hours.
You weren't exhausted enough.
I
get exhausted.
I get exhausted, too, but
I don't
sleep.
I don't see how that's possible.
I get between 3 and 5 hours of sleep on a good night, mostly.
Have you slept 8 hours before?
Oh, yeah, I can on the weekends because I don't have to wake up. It's not staying asleep that's my problem. It's getting to sleep is my problem.
I have that problem too.
I can.
I have that problem too. But
I don't believe that because of the amount of times I found you sleeping with a video game controller in your hands and your fingers on the fucking buttons. And that could never happen with me. I would have to go to bed, turn off the lights, cut all the sound off, run a fan, lay there and switch from side to side while moving the pillow and turning the pillow so it's still cool. Trying all kinds of different combinations of laying there until I finally get up. And
have you ever just tried to stay in the same position?
I never tried that before when I was sleeping.
That's the only time
he's
I
always just
sleep.
Flailing around.
Well, you've tried everything. Moving. I have taken. There are nights where I take sleeping pills, like 3 Benadryl, and I don't sleep, and I just go to work. And
have you been to the doctor?
Are you worried?
Well, no, because I'm worried. I don't like. But here's the thing: I don't like the way that drugs make you sleep. They make you feel shitty in the morning.
And you'd rather just not sleep
at all.
Feel terrible.
If I take a Benadryl and I wake up in the morning, it's groggy and the day's ruined.
I did almost 5 days without sleep when I was about like 5 or 6 years ago. And it was to the point where I was walking around and I felt like I was walking around in a dream.
Yeah.
Like my legs weren't my legs. Like
that's how I feel after one night.
You don't
even
feel tired anymore and like your eyes burn because they haven't been closed in 4 days, 5 days. And it's not
and
meth,
back,
people. It's you, not meth. I
your
swear
back
to
hurts.
God.
You get like that deep ache in your back from not being able to relax and your muscles relax. Kind of.
I don't know. I mean, I've got in my shoulders and stuff. I don't really get achy and pain.
I can still smell that gefilte fish. Jesus, man.
Mm. Well, that's probably the
it's
reason.
It's gonna be all
those
over.
Those plates have got to go.
The plates.
It's like a cat food.
Have you ever tried having a 1 glass of milk?
Yes, I've tried drinking.
Have you ever had your mom rub?
Have
your
you tried
feet?
Exercise?
Have
you
tried
your
mom
to
rub your feet?
You know, where you take a half a graham cracker, eat it.
Half a graham cracker?
You guys didn't see that Flanders episode?
No, I did not.
You ever just choke yourself until you pass out?
No.
Because then once you pass out, you'll let go and you won't choke yourself to death.
My neck is too big. I can't
you'll just choke
myself.
Yourself to unconsciousness. Okay, sorry to change subjects here, but that mystery guest on the front porch, I don't know exactly how to feel about this, because it's a letter from the bank... For my wife. I'm assuming it's a neighbor who got one of our letters by mistake.
That's exactly what it was.
But instead of sticking it like in the door or somewhere safe, she sets it like awkwardly on the edge of my patio.
So that you see it when you fucking come
do you
out.
Have
any little gust of wind would have knocked it into the
do you have a
bushes.
Mailbox? Do you have a mailbox?
Yeah.
Why the fuck wouldn't you put someone's mail in their mailbox?
Well, it's not a mailbox. It's a key open little
thing. Okay.
Down the street.
That, what the fuck are you bitching about, you crybaby?
I don't know.
Yeah, well, you are kind of crying a little bit, you know, about it.
It's not like it's opened and it has a picture of her naked in it.
It should have. Oh, well.
I do have a would you rather kind of question that I would like to ask the gentleman.
Oh, you floated this to me earlier and you didn't tell me what it was.
Yeah, because I wanted your genuine reaction.
Breaking the fourth wall again, folks, because he told me he had something to bring to the show.
Will you stop it with your fucking theater major shit?
Yeah,
I don't know anything about
the fourth wall is a comic book
about.
Reference. It's like Deadpool breaking the fourth wall. Why don't you suck a fat dick? Because if you want to talk about bullshit like that, I'll start talking about comic books, like how they redesigned Lobo recently in the New 52.
You were pissed about
that. My favorite comic book character.
You were so pissed.
They make him look like a little emo fucking fruitcake.
Lobo,
the second picture.
Lobo
picture.
Was the name of a gay porn star. I happen to know.
He was. But the one that wasn't approved should have been the one that was.
I think that was the one that was approved, actually. I think the first one, it was all like little emo.
That's so terrible. The second one's...
I don't even know what you're talking about.
I mean, folks, recently the DC Comics universe, where Superman, Batman, Green Lantern, all that shit exists, like a couple years ago, rebooted their universe and made it the New 52, where they have 52 comics and 52 universes.
Joker's awesome.
But they maintained all the Batman continuity. All they did was cut Joker's face off and have it strap it on like a fucking
mask. Why would they completely change shit?
Which is... Because the only thing that was working was Green Lantern and Batman, and they kept all those continuities moderately intact.
What about Superman?
Wait.
He's not married to Lois Lane anymore.
Well,
he doesn't work on the Daily Planet currently. His costume has been completely redesigned by Jim Lee, so it's got lots of 90s stripes and lines on it.
Is there any truth to the rumor I've heard that Ben Affleck...
Ben Affleck, yeah, he's been cast as Batman.
Ben Affleck is the next Batman.
Jiggly? Yeah,
I'm fine with it. Whatever. I'm a big comic book nerd.
I don't give a fuck.
It'll probably be good because they're going to direct it.
I like the idea of Batman. They've talked about it, how Batman is already going to be established as Batman before Superman even came onto the scene. He's a little older than Henry Cavill. He's gonna be an established superhero.
Who the fuck is Henry Cavill?
The guy who played Superman.
I even know that, and I haven't seen the Superman. The Superman was good, though, right? And
that's it had no heart. It was good.
You said it was great when you saw
it.
It
was
exciting,
but it's like,
I enjoyed it.
It's exciting, but there was no heart to it. It's like
somebody read reviews and critiques.
Metropolis fighting Zod, smashing through buildings, killing thousands. He didn't try to save one person.
Character development.
He didn't try to save one person. His whole point of Superman is to
save
people.
Yeah,
he's got to
destroy fucking Zod from killing everybody.
Yeah, I don't know. Try to take it out of the city.
You hear that, people? If you shoot someone who's about to murder a woman, that doesn't make you a hero in Turlet's book.
Damn
right. Apparently, yeah. Okay, so what would now the thought experiment?
Oh, yeah,
okay.
Sorry to diverge on
derailed
that.
Derailed
never
just
got
a little
into
bit.
My nerd brain in the show before. But
yeah, it's okay. Yeah. You were pissed.
Don't
Friday.
Worry.
You
well,
were
Lobo is my favorite DC Comics character. I've always liked him. He's just a greasy space biker.
He was
intergalactic
emo
bounty
fuck.
Hunter.
Huh? Emo little fuck in that picture.
They make he's just a heavy metal dude, you know, guy with a big old chain, and now they give him a laser chain because he can't have just a chain; it's got to have lasers on it.
When I think of Lobo, I think of a mess smoking biker, like with
that
a fucking vest.
He's got a radio in his head that constantly broadcasts heavy metal music.
Yeah.
He can't get it out.
No
he
kidding,
it.
That's ridiculous. How
I
could
love
they
Lobo.
Take that out?
He's the last Zarnian. He killed his entire species.
Yeah, I don't know anything about him, but
okay.
But go ahead.
What's your thought experiment, Hamtackle?
Oh, just fling a filter fish on me, didn't you?
That's what you get.
Cocksucker.
You're gonna smell of that.
All right, I've got a... this is mostly pertinent to you, Terlet. I want to make sure that you sort of field this question first. But really, we could all sort of ponder it. And it is... you have a wife, lovely lady Terlet.
I married a real human woman.
You did, and... you have a mom.
She's still alive and kicking.
Here's the thing. Would you rather...
Oh, fuck.
...have sex with your mom's body with your wife's brain in it? Or your wife's body with your mom's brain in it?
Oh, God. You didn't get this off the Reddit or something. This is your own creation?
Well, no. I saw this online and I thought we should probably talk about it. I'm not going to try to take credit here. But thanks for putting me on the spot.
Have sex with your mom with your wife's brain
Your
in
mom's
it?
Body with your yeah. significant other's brain... Or your wife's body with your mother's
okay,
brain.
Okay, you have 10 seconds.
She's gonna remember. Let's put it that way.
Who's gonna remember?
Both of them. Well, whoever's mind's in there is gonna remember it. So you got it.
So why is there a reason why I have to have sex? Or it's just like you just have to have sex? But
no.
That's it.
Gunshot. We're gonna kill your whole family unless you make this choice. You're gonna make the choice.
I think my family might be okay with.
No, here's the thing. Both both
no
your wife's brain and your mother's brain are fucking ready to go.
If you don't choose the choices made for you.
Yes, okay, there you go.
Yeah.
You know, I'll go with my wife's body because maybe my mom's a great lay. Maybe she'll put a lot into it. You never know. What if? What if she's like, knows it has to happen? I mean, I'd rather fuck my wife's body than my mom's body, for the love of Christ.
Yeah, but you're saying...
My mom's in there like, you know what? It's not my body. I'm
you're saying you're fucking the person. You're saying you're fucking the person, not the whole.
I just know my wife is... My wife's brain is going to go back into her body and be... My wife's brain is going to go back into her body and be like, I am so fucking sore.
Yeah. But by the same token, you know your mom could take it. I mean, you know your mom could... She, you know, probably durable, right?
Jesus, man. I'm not going to even go
there.
No,
you have to answer it, too. I just gave a decent explanation. What's your perspective there?
I like your take on it, personally.
But your mom emotionally will be into it?
No, there's no way I'm having sex with anything that's got my mom's brain in it.
You both know my mother and how she's...
If there's a woman and it's in your mom's body, it's speaking with your mom's voice. So she's like, Jimmy Chapsworth. It's not.
It's her vocal cords. The vocal cords of the girl you're fucking.
Yeah, it's your mom's voice in her own body. It's not. Like, I'm not making it like a shitty Eddie Murphy movie where he inhabits somebody else's body and it's Eddie Murphy's voice.
Wasn't that exact plot of like Weekend at Bernie's 4?
Well, that was the dead mom, and they were all taking turns fucking her.
Okay, well, to get back to the point of my mother, you both know her, and she would take one for the team. She would. She'd be like, "Oh my god,
sounds like something that's happened before.
Our whole family's gonna die if I don't do this."
My mom's a good lady. She should be down.
I would rather fuck the physical husk, you know, of whatever, whoever it would be in my life at that point, because I can't maintain a relationship to save my life. You know, whatever. I don't care.
When you're talking about the physical husk, I'm missing you. What are you talking about here? You're just talking about you'd rather fuck
I don't
want to
fuck my
shell.
Mom's physical body. No, there's no way I can do that. I love my mom to death.
There's your girlfriend in there. I'm like, come on, put it in my ass.
Yeah, there's no way.
Oh, Chapsworth is so big in here. This is different.
No, I rely on physical...
But she's there.
Will you guys shut the fuck
really
up
hurt.
For a
don't
second?
Don't push that hard.
I rely on physical attraction much more than mental attraction because I'm shallow.
Yeah, if I have to fuck, I'm not going to be able to fuck my
There's
mom's
no
body.
Way. I couldn't get hard. I blow my brains out. Fuck it. I can't deal with it.
Don't forget your lunch.
Either way, it's not really ideal. Let's put it that way.
No, absolutely. But if you have to choose... What's the lesser of two evils? That's my lesser of two evils. What the fuck is yours?
I just said that I couldn't fuck anything with my mom's brains. I just couldn't.
You would have to fuck your mom's physical body.
She wouldn't be there.
Yeah, but your mom's
She
physical
wouldn't
body.
Be there.
Or she'll go back in and be like, it's so sore and ripped up.
You know
you're
what?
Go
it'd
to
be
sort of
like going to the dentist.
God.
I love how you're able to rationalize shit in your fucking screwed up brain.
She can't be there. She can't be there. It's the only way for her not to be there.
Okay, well let's add a little...
You're like, I could totally bone out with just my mom in a room.
Add a little nuance to it. would the brain still be in the body from there
the
on
The brains
out?
Are swapped.
Yeah, but is it going to stay that way? Or are they
no,
gonna go
they
back
go back home? After.
Yeah, it flips back. As soon as you come, they flip back.
So
you're still wiping it off her belly, and she's like, ah!
Oh my God. As soon as you climax, the fucking whatever it is reversed.
As soon as you climax,
that moment
mom's
when you realize you just came inside your mom like, and now
she
knows it.
Better than she just sat there for 17 minutes of the same bullshit.
17 minutes, I think.
You saw it would be a minute and a half.
Well, no, come on. You gotta add in some kind of multiplier for your fucking your mom's body.
And then what if you like you can only get off if you're degrading the woman and your girlfriend's into that, but your mom's not, but your girlfriend's in your mom's body.
Sounds a little bit
like,
too personal.
Your mom goes back into her body and her cheeks are all red from being slapped and covered in cum.
She's got like a fucking broken occipital lobe and shit.
I think all of our mothers
I can't come without punching
would be willing to go through that bullshit.
Should we get one of our moms on the phone right now and find out?
Should we?
Should we call your mom?
Yeah, let's do it.
No, we're not doing it.
Why?
Come That's on. A horrible idea.
No, let's do this.
You know
real
what?
Fast.
Why not? Let's call
let's
your
do
mom.
This. My mom's down
What's
for this.
What's on the speakerphone right here?
My mom's down for this.
Oh, fuck. Oh.
This we'll is horrible.
Try to use code names if you can. Folks,
this
we're
is
going to
require some editing.
Mr. Duffer's mom. This is a bad idea.
Let's just try it.
Not too close.
Okay, that's probably good.
You do the talking.
I will.
Of course. You
ask her the question.
No, I'm not.
I'm not going to
ask her.
Hey, Ma.
Hey, baby.
Hey, don't say any names because we're doing a podcast. We got a thought experiment.
Hey, welcome,
real fast.
Sir Chatsworth's mom to Master Bastard, the podcast with Glaster.
Okay. I'm sorry. Hamtackle's going to ask you a thought experiment real fast.
I can't ask just her. Ask. It doesn't apply to her.
Just though. Fucking ask.
No, the, I'll tell her what the question was.
Can you ask if she's okay with it or she's not?
Are you okay with this?
Slow down with the...
Okay, are you okay with us asking you a horrible question because it's going to be hilarious?
Oh, go ahead.
Okay.
It's not... I can't ask you the question because it doesn't apply to you. I'll tell you what the question was.
Yeah, it's to me.
The question is, would you... Like, for... If Chapsworth here had, like, a significant other, would he rather have sex with her with your brain in it or with you with her brain in it?
And I responded, and this is how I responded. I said, I would fuck the husk of whatever girl it was with your brain in it because you'd be willing to take something like that for the team because I cannot physically be attracted
to you,
you know, and that's what it would take for me to become hard.
Brilliant.
Okay.
So you're okay with that? Because we're setting it up right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
How would you?
Okay, she says okay.
How would you feel about that, Ma?
I imagine it's not ideal.
You want to do, babe? I'm on your team.
All right.
That's too nice. My mom would hang.
Your
hung
mom
up
would have hung up
now.
Already.
Yeah,
she
hung up twice.
Thanks, Ma. I love you.
See you. I love you.
Bye.
Bye.
That's too fucking funny, man.
We should have let her talk more, but oh well. I wanted to hear her side of the whole thing.
Well, no, I think she was a little taken aback. I mean, it's not
oh,
a normal...
well, hey, Chapsworth's dad! You know, your son just called me talking about, you know, having sex with me, having sex with my body, and like, you know, or just having a passionate moment with eye contact with my brain inside another woman. What do you think of that?
You heard her. I'm on your team, whatever it takes.
Yeah, whatever you want.
I hope she didn't misunderstand and you're going to get home and she's waiting for you in a 90 or something. Mm-hmm.
You said, yeah, it's probably happened.
Before. What?
We didn't do thought experiments before, did we? Did we do my other one?
I think we did the one thought experiment. We just didn't explore it very well. One where, would you rather have a tongue in your asshole or no tongue at all?
We did that.
We did it, but we had the wrong setup. We said, like...
Well, no, I was thinking more along the lines of the homophobic one.
Okay.
Homophobic one?
Shoot.
Yeah, would you rather... have sex with one man 20 different times or just get it all over with 20 men all at once?
20 men all at once, all to climax.
They all have to leave with a smile on their face, then, no matter how rough they like it.
Did we have this one? I thought
we haven't done this one.
No? Okay, there's no risk of disease.
No, of course not. Come on now, we live in the 21st century.
This is like either 20 men, you bring them all to climax in one day.
It's all going to be over with. You are going to remember it the rest of your life.
This is a question for straight men, because a gay man would have a problem with this.
Well, who knows?
Maybe he's like in a committed relationship.
Maybe they're monogamous, and you're just being a fucking
jerk. I didn't mean to say that all gay men are not monogamous.
Or they're promiscuous. Disclaimer out there.
So, I mean, but think about it. It's somebody who personally would find participating in homosexual sex to be dispalatable, unpalatable, not really a word.
Not enjoyable.
Unpalatable.
He stare at me in the eyes when he say that.
So, but if there's this one man 20 times, it has to be 20 different days.
Here's the thing. No. You have to be up for it 20 straight times.
You have to bring him to orgasm.
You both
times?
Have to. Both have to. And
you both have to climax 20 times.
Both.
But what about the 20 men in one day? Do you have to climax 20 times?
No, you just say, if it's a 20 men in one day, they just have to leave with smiles.
They have to all come, you have to at least come once.
It's a mutual kind of a relationship when you choose the one guy. You know what? You're going to get to know him. You're going to know what kind of coffee this guy likes.
You're going to know what
he wears on Tuesdays. You're going to know the manufacturer of the scent that he wears and he sprays all over his nethers so that you don't have to deal with the stink.
It might get easier and easier, too, because you're going to know how to what's going to
get
him off.
It would get easier.
Like, if I poke right here and give a little tug here, it's going to get over it with a lot quicker.
I guarantee you at the end of 20 days, you would not feel strange sharing a toothbrush.
It has to be 20 straight days or just 20 times over a period of time?
You have to do 20 separate occasions in which you make love.
All right, can I feel this one first?
You, of
Please.
Course. I all eyes are on you.
Can
so
I make it
started.
So we don't make love, that we just fuck really hard? Makes it really hot.
There's no way I could take 20 men at once. I would fucking slit my own throat.
Tried it once and it didn't work.
Yeah.
Just like there's all no of them way. Standing feeling like you're like a...
I've seen...
Like you stole somebody's baby and they're all microphones in your face when you get arrested.
I've seen gangbangs.
You're allowed to have knee pads, Chapsworth.
I've seen gangbangs. There's no way... Well, so I could just sit there and blow 20 dudes?
Well, no, they're going to go
your hands,
in,
your ass, your mouth, whatever you want.
Yeah,
you
nothing's
going to
be non-consensual, but there's 20 of them. They're going to do it all at one time.
Yeah, you still got your foreskin, Chapsworth. Just dock with a couple gentlemen. Just wrap your foreskin around their tip.
There is docking, isn't there? Fluid chamber.
You're going to have to give up the ass. Let's put it that way. Mouth and ass, at least. And you still, you can do a couple of them.
You can do a flying eagle.
A couple are going to be handy, but that's going to be while you got one in the mouth.
Two in the ass, one in the mouth, one in each hand.
Flying eagle. Slam dunk.
Screaming.
The same man 20 times, for sure. Absolutely.
Because you know what? Because one guy can keep a secret.
It's not trauma. It's not trauma at that point.
One guy can keep a secret. 20 guys, everybody's going to know.
Well, I don't necessarily care about that. I care about my mental health.
At the same time, how much money would it take to get over the whole experience? I guess you
would have to buy...
You could spend the rest of your life justifying the one man. 20 men, you'd be like crying about it to your wife in 30 years.
Yeah, holding that shit in and then having an anxiety attack at 70.
It's an anxiety attack where you just get like long toenails and fingernails and just sort of go unwashed for 3 months.
Or blow away 30 dudes in a bank.
Well, let's get real dark.
Blow 30 dudes in a bank.
Yeah,
I think we're taking the gangbang thing too far. Now you're going for 30 guys. 20's not enough for you. Is this what you're trying to say?
Well, I think I crossed a barrier there with you two, Jesus. It was metaphorical. It wasn't serious. You both can fuck off. Anyway,
we're two of the guys in the 20-man gangbang, so we are going to fuck off.
I would...
I'm there twice. I'm going to get back in line.
Can you choose your partner?
If they have a list of 50 men, you got to choose 20?
No, it's Dungeons & Dragons style. You're rolling it.
Oh, yeah, okay, roll dice.
Out of the 20 that are there.
So there's a 90% chance of one of those men saying, I'm going to butter your bread.
Well, that's fine. I would take that. I would take the same man's one time.
I think you would anyways, right? Wouldn't you? Or would you just be like, fuck, man, at least tomorrow it will be over.
Hey, at least I'll have an experience.
At least tomorrow it will be over.
Okay, I'll take devil's advocate. 20 at once. Get it over with. Gentlemen, line up. Or all at once, just do whatever you need to do. I'm gonna put on a show, and if they happen to like jerk themselves off while I'm like doing a little dance,
if you do good, it goes faster.
Yeah, I can. There's a chance I can do like a Maharani.
But that really applies for either one, really, either choice.
You know,
the better you perform, the quicker it's over.
Exotic shape. I could like do a little dance and maybe provoke them to like, hey, why don't you
play
with your manhood while I perform? And if they achieve climax from watching,
that's
the dance,
okay. They just have to leave with a smile. And that's the thing. It's like you do have sort of an eggplanty, sort of sleek kind of
thank you
cuisine going about you.
Yes, a very eggplanty, pear-shaped.
I didn't say shaped. I meant more of your bruised color.
Oh, thanks. I do bruise easily, especially around my genitals.
Well, that's because you're none too gentle with them. That's a problem.
So you automatically volunteered to bang one guy 20 times, no
absolutely
problem. Where I said I'm going to try to get by with the 20 guys, with any of them.
You said he bangs the other guy. It's a mutual. This is a two-way street we're talking.
Oh, you're both topping and bottom. Top or bottom?
Yes.
No, I could jerk off while he's banging me.
No. He could jerk off. You're going to be helped.
Yeah, you can't use your own hands.
Oh,
it's not like, okay, well, yeah, just have a conversation with the dude. We sit on opposite sides of a room.
You want some Campbell's soup?
Hey, that could be one night.
We go, we watch fucking basketball.
That could be
we
one
go
night.
Go watch basketball.
That could be fucking one night. If he's into sports and we're both into football, I'd take him to
he's
a football
he's into sports,
game.
He wants you to wear shoulder pads, and he's going to bend you over and just
how
fuck
do you
him
know
in the ass.
This is all random. How the fuck would you know that?
Because he's into it. That's how I know, and because it's my thought experiment. And I'm telling you that you're not getting away with a passive homosexual experience in this thought experiment. I mean, you're all in either way. You're
okay,
both feet.
No, well,
both feet.
Some days could be a passive sexual experience.
Well,
if he had a rough night in sleep. He just
wants
to
cuddle. Let's jerk off while staring into each other's eyes.
He just wants to rub on your thigh and come.
Yeah, that's it.
Just into his cuddle and sleep.
He needs to be you rubbing his prostate and him rubbing yours in order to finish off.
No, that's not. No, it's random. You can't choose.
Okay. You're
going to
get an
69.
Equal. Okay, here. You're going to get an equal number of mouth shots, ass shots, hand shots, and mutual masturbation.
So
you
there's
no matter
times.
You can't. You cannot change the fucking stipulations.
No, I just
after
did.
I chose.
Look what just happened. I don't know if you were paying attention, but this is just what happened right now. Is the whole experiment changed?
Well. Jasper just threw a piece of paper and right in Hamtackle's cleavage.
I didn't get it shot. In there, did I?
It just stuck to my neck. I'm sweating.
You're sweating.
Your neck, ass, face, back, and neck?
Ass, back, neck, face,
tits
and ass.
Tits and ass.
Tits, neck, ass, back, neck, and ass.
Face, neck, ass, back, and neck. Oh, fuck.
You were fondling my phone. Why can't
so,
I
guys, how
you?
How
all right, you choose, dick fuck.
You're right, because that's a theft and that's rape.
Well, apparently it's just an HR violation anymore.
Yeah, I know. So fucking, who would know?
Who's HR here? You?
I'm human relations on this podcast.
Uh-huh.
Human resources, you mean?
Or... No, I call it relations.
Is it like more of an intimate term?
Human resources.
Aren't you married?
Okay,
all right, this
now,
dog.
Okay, all the chicks in human resources are fucking pigs.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
They
goodness.
Really are. Okay, go.
Like what happened?
Your thought. Okay, what is your choice?
Oh, I already said I would do. I'd do a combo. I'd go 21. I'd invite that first guy in for the 21.
Could you split it up? Bang, can bang, I bang, like, do 10
days.
Guys at once and that
20
one
days,
guy? 10
days, 20 men.
Can you divide it up?
It's a marathon.
Can you divide it up? Can I do 10 guys at once and that one guy 10 times?
No, they're all going and we're going to meet tomorrow at the same time, same place.
Oh, good, because I put that thing on Craigslist. We're set.
20 days. 20 days.
So straight. How do you guys think Ramtang...
I don't do anything half-assed.
How would Ramtang...
Literally and figuratively.
I would think I would have,
you know... So this fucking one time, white to black, I was like...
Yeah, I'll be white, black.
Who says those white and black puns?
Constantly.
You stay white there, we'll be right white black, or whatever it is.
Yeah. he would probably choose 20 men all at once, I would think.
Oh,
he would power through it. He is a man
yeah,
of passion.
He is. He wouldn't
like,
want to deal
this.
With... He wouldn't want to have that lingering over him, I would think.
Well, the thing is, he also has that upset tummy, so they'd have some shitty dicks. He'd be the kind of guy where they're like the little boy trying to plug the dike with his finger in his ass, and it's just like spraying out the sides like Kool-Aid Man.
like in 20 minutes with my gefilte fish?
Oh, like those guys wouldn't enjoy it, so he has to be moot from it.
Oh, the hair. The hair on him.
On who? Oh, on him?
On Ramtang, yeah. Hairy man.
That thick orange.
Are you hairy? None of you are hairy, right?
Oh, I'm not hairy.
It's moderately hairy. I've got like chest hair.
I have just a little patch.
Well, we've all... Hamtackle is the hairiest of the three.
Yeah.
Chapsworth, you and I are pretty similar with it. Can I say there?
What about best belly hair?
Yeah.
I got more belly hair than you.
I got belly hair.
I don't know.
I got belly hair.
We're three clammy whitefish belly fucks.
Oh, those are
fat. Oh, sweet Jesus.
They're super white. This
For some
is
reason,
like...
when you looked up your shirt, I totally expected a Kawato ham tackle.
I had that removed.
Yeah. Yeah. The scar tissue. Oh. I have to massage it every night.
Fuck. Well,
I did see a video of a mummified baby being removed from an 85-year-old woman. That's pretty crazy.
Go on.
What?
It was a video of a woman receiving some kind of surgery for what they thought was a tumor turned out to be a mummified baby in her womb.
So it's just a baby that was encased in her belly?
Yeah, well, she got pregnant and kind of just stopped. And she still was big for, like, ever.
What the fuck?
It was just walled over by the...
Calcified.
Yeah.
Calcified. Mm-hmm. It was like a rock baby.
Did it still have its... Did it still retain structure? Or was it just like a fucking...
They might be able to, like, get it out and shock it and it's okay. Just kidding.
Terrified.
Good lord, man. I just
no, she's like an 85-year-old woman. They're like, oh, she wandered out of some village.
Oh, okay.
Of course it's some village. And she's like, oh, I've got this gigantic, like, super heavy tumor. And they took her in and were like, oh, it's actually you're the baby that you knew you totally were pregnant and it kind of never came out of you. And how did you not know that it was, yeah, this was a baby?
That's got to look crazy. Did she keep it? Did you try to dress it? Like, it's like a...
I think they probably...
It's like trying to dress up
they
fucking...
They probably buried it, I would assume. And probably, like, the hospital
well,
before they even told
it?
Her what it was.
Because it could have turned into a fucking
medicine.
It was
medicine. Like India or something. Come on. Oh, like, it's right. Not India
now
or China.
Now it's powdered and ground up and being snorted by people as a cure for impotency.
Yeah, like, it's not going to be India or China.
I
come
was
on.
Thinking you were talking about an actual mummy where they tried to
mummified
take...
baby, like...
Well, no, where they tried to take a baby out of a mummy is what I said. Like... They found a mummy baby.
No, they found a woman walking around the village with a mummified baby in her womb.
A live woman with a dead child.
Or are you trying to say a woman gave birth to a mummy? It's like,
no. I was thinking they like unearthed a tomb with this
pregnant
mummy.
With a pregnant lady.
No, no,
that's what I thought you were talking about.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah, that would be awesome. That's not as hilarious.
No.
And I saw the video, which is, you know, a horrible video with, like, an 85-year-old woman's nudity.
Climax.
Oh, man, come on.
Right in, yeah,
it was more an anticipation of the video. Afterwards, I was kind of disappointed.
And she also had a real hairy bush, so it really helped out.
Of course she does. She's, like, fucking 85 years old and from Mid-East Asia.
All right, now you're speaking my language. Ladies and gentlemen, on that
She was
note,
wearing a kerchief on her hair, okay? Picture it.
Kerchief.
Well, no, like in the earlier pictures they show over, yeah. Mm. You know, some fishmonger.
Is that another word for bandana?
Fishmonger. I've always loved that word. Anyway.
Fuck. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you once again for joining us on Master Bastard. It's a podcast. There's no Ramtang.
Don't say it.
We'll give Ramtang the final word this week. Hey, Ramtang, give us a sign out.
We'll be white, black next week.
Black, white. He's the most hip-hop Irishman I know. He's more hip-hop than a House of Pain.
He's taller, too. Much taller.
All right. Well, we miss him, and we hope he returns soon.
He'll be better. He'll be better when he gets out of jail.
I agree with him. She looked 18.
She did.
I know. Like, we haven't all been there at least three times.
And she all... I mean, you know, it didn't look like a he, either. It looked like a real woman.
I know.
So, I mean...
Except whatever. For the, you know...
The You know, it was a He-Man backpack, but come
yeah,
on.
Yeah, you pay the price. You pay the price. Folks, we'll see you next week. Thanks for joining us on Mechanophilia, which is a sexual attraction to cars or other mechanics. Or Morphophilia.
I'm attracted to mechanics.
Particular body shapes or sizes.
I think Cumberbatch would be the best. Felix Cumberbatch.
There's a cat getting raped in the background.
That's Peck the cat. She wants attention, so she meows.
Okay, that's what it is.
Yeah. Folks, this show has been brought to you by Peck the Cat. We'll see you next time.